Hello class, good morning everyone. So in the previous class we have finished one of the chapters from your history. So today let us do the other section, that is social and political life part 3, which is also called civics. Okay, let us see the first chapter, that is diversity, page number 219. What do you mean by diversity? Diversity is basically, you know, being different from one another. In simple layman's term, if you see, it's also mentioned in the text. As I'll read under the text, you please mark those things. So to be different from one another is called diversity. To start with the chapter, there's a very good example right above the text that is being mentioned about a particular character, about what name called Mansi. Okay, I'll just read out the example, listen to it. I hope you all are ready with the textbook. So here it goes. Mansi has just come back from Mumbai, where she went to attend her cousin sister's Nisha's wedding. While Nisha is Punjabi, she got married to a Christian boy from Kerala. Mansi's mami, which means maternal uncle's wife, who is Nisha's mother, is Bengali, and Mansi's aunt, who is Nisha's paternal aunt, is married to a Gujarati. So the marriage was full of diverse customs and traditions of different regions, which means areas, different areas. There was a church wedding in the morning and a Punjabi-Bengali mixed wedding in the evening, where people danced to Bhangra tunes and loud music, and later traditional Shehnai was played when the actual rituals took place. The food platter was a diverse affair as well, as delicacies from different regions were served. Mansi is too excited. She wants to share all this with her friends. So see, it's one of a kind. Just imagine a wedding, event like wedding, where, you know, so many different types of rituals, customs are being followed, as because the relatives or, you know, the person to whom the marriage is getting tied with belongs from another religion. So they have got a different tradition, different custom, whereas, but at the same time, keeping in view, keeping in respect of all the traditions of be the bride or the bridegroom, all are being practiced, all are being followed, and with different types of the food delicacies that, you know, different people have got, different locality, they have got different type of food, different type of dishes. So all those are being prepared. It's one of a kind of a marriage, which generally we tend to see very less. So how nice it would be, how great would it be, because why? Because of the differences, right? Because generally that is what makes unique about this marriage. That is what makes the marriage special, the diversity. So that is what is called diversity in one term. That means to be different from one another. So now let us go to the text. The state of being different from one another is called diversity. Underline that. Diversity can be in all fields of life. In your class, you will find children who speak different languages, celebrate different festivals, like to play different games, and study different subjects. When you go to a shop to buy a pen, you will find different varieties of it. You can choose the one that suits your requirement. Diversity is present in every field of life. It adds variety and makes our life more interesting. Variety, in the sense, I would say that, you know, it adds more color to our life. That is what is important. Okay? Otherwise, our life would have been, imagine staying in a world, staying in a house, okay, staying in a society where everything is just black and white, nothing else. I don't know whether you guys have come across or not, but we did, I did, you know, in my childhood days, the televisions that we have today, the color televisions, we didn't have during those days then. It was black and white. Anything, no matter whatever color was it, everything was visible just in two color, that is either black or white. So, but still, people watched it. I'm not saying that people didn't like it. They did. But it was not that much fascinating as it is today. As because different colors, the different colors of attire, dresses, and all, so many things. It makes it unique. It makes it more colorful. It makes it more interesting, more lively. That is what the chapter is saying. So in each and every sphere of life, you will find diversity. You will find, you know, what do you call, variety, differences, and which is why life is, that is one of the reason you can say that life is so interesting. So some of the examples they have given in the book, right in the first para itself, starting from your classroom, and it goes up till the things that we buy from a shop, be it a pen or a pencil. Even in a pen, even for a pencil also, there are different varieties, different companies of pencils. Some of you may prefer this, well, the other may prefer the another one. Let us see now diversity in India. India is a country of diversities. Diversity has been one of our most remarkable features. People belonging to different religions and speaking different languages live in India. However, in spite of this diversity, a basic unity binds us together. This lends us our identity as Indians. People of India are Indians first. All other identities come later. Underline that. People of India are Indians first. All other identities come later. You know, basically, this line has, even though it's just a one small simple sentence, but it has got a very big impact. I'll tell you what does it mean. Today, say you, I, no matter from wherever we belong from Assam or Delhi or Punjab or Madras, it doesn't matter. But when we go to a different country, abroad, okay, country other than ours, all right, you may be from Punjab, from Delhi, from Kerala, from Assam, from whatever. But the moment we go out there, they don't recognize us. They don't, brand us as this man is from Kerala of India. This man is from Punjab, which is in India. This man is from Assam, which is in India. No. The simple identity, the way we are being identified out there in abroad is that he's an Indian. She is an Indian from India, which means we are Indian first. And then next comes our regional. Those are secondary things. So the primary identity is, no matter whatever differences we have, the variations that we have, but we are Indians. Underlying the spirit of unity in diversity determines our identity as Indians. And that is known as integral part of our heritage. Underline. Which means, in simple term, let me explain. The spirit of unity, okay? The spirit of unity in diversity, that is, as I told you, that's the main identity of our Indians, and that is the main integral part of our heritage. So basically, see, in our country, there are, as per the Constitution of India, there are somewhere around, 22 scheduled languages which are being recognized by the Constitution of India, okay, recognized languages. And other than that, there are still many more languages. Once I remember I came across an article, okay, I don't know which article, I forgot that, but there are somewhere around more than 100 dialects, regional languages, local languages, which are being spoken in our country, right? But no matter whatever it is, there is just one example. No matter even we speak more than 100 dialects, but what we are an Indian. Next comes the history of diversity. So these differences that we have, okay, or the variations that we have, let's see from where it originated, how that, so much of differences came within us, among us, okay, that India has got so much of diversity. Let's see this. In the past, India was a very rich country. People from different parts of the world came to India to control its wealth. Underline that. People from different parts of the world came to India. But what was the purpose? In simple language, to, snatch, to grab our wealth. Through various means like businesses and all. Gradually, they settled down and mingled with people living here. You will read more on this in your history lessons. People who came from outside adopted certain elements of our culture while retaining some elements of their own culture. This intermingling of cultures led to the emergence of new languages, dance forms, schools of music and paintings, new cuisines and religion. The different cultures thus influenced one another and brought about diversity. All right. So, these people, those who came to India from different parts of the world with an intention to, to capture or to drain our wealth, okay, these people, when they came here, they started settling down here. And as they started settling down here, living out here, okay, now, that's, they came from a different place. So along with them, they brought their culture, their tradition, and we had our own culture, our own tradition. So as a result, it got intermingled, theirs and ours, okay? It got combined. And as it got combined, a new, which led to the emergence of a new culture, a little bit of theirs, some portion of ours, okay? Likewise, new languages, new tradition, new dance forms, new music, new different types of painting, different type of food habits and all, where this all emerged, okay? And this is how you can say different cultures influence one another, and we have this diversity today, the variations that we have today. Next, that is kinds of diversity. Kinds of diversity, I'll take it in the next class. I'll keep the class here for today. So please go through the text. Read the text thoroughly. That is what is more important. Okay. Read each and every single word. Do not skip any line. Fine. So see you in the next class. Take care, everybody.